summer of 2001, life in Palm Springs was good. I had the most successful judo school in the whole part of the county.
Get a good grip, chest to chest.
Good students, good friends. I've been competing in judo internationally for a number of years. Your entire life is focused on your upcoming event. And all of a sudden, I stopped. And I looked around, I felt like every day was predictable. But to feel awake, you need some kind of challenge. I decided to ride a motorcycle to the tip of South America and back.
It can happen in the light of day or the dead of night. An innocent person is abducted.
Glenn Hegstad is on the adventure of a lifetime.
It's one of those dream rides you never want to end.
A year-long motorcycle trip from his home in Palm Springs, California.
Adventure travel is really the essence of my life at this point.
Through Mexico, Central America, and all the way to the tip of South America and back. After traveling 5,000 miles through Mexico and Central America, he rode into Bogota, Colombia, and into the crossfire of a brutal 30-year civil war.
I was just outside Medellin, and I was stopped at a roadblock and taken prisoner by the National Liberation Army.
It's a Marxist group.
One guy that seemed like he was in control there, they ordered me off the bike. And so I'm standing there with my hands up, and they're yelling and screaming. I can never remember a time where I was thinking that fast. It's a pretty powerful moment when you believe that you're gonna die in the next few seconds. He popped around, and it was an ear-splitting noise. I did not believe I was alive. As I'm being led away, I'm looking at the people on the bus like, I'm shouting with my eyes, tell somebody what you saw.
Glenn was now at the mercy of the ELN, an infamous Colombian revolutionary group. During the next 5 weeks, Glenn was tortured and starved, not to mention the mind games they would play on him about false rescue attempts and even his own execution.
I got a gun in my face.
He initiated his Chinese meditation training and went on a hunger strike.
The only way to take control was to sabotage my own health. I'm done with their timetable. We're going to go on mine.
Glenn then fabricated a case of prostate cancer, forcing nosebleeds and directing the blood onto his crotch.
The only food that I've had is my own blood.
Once Glenn had gotten to the point of complete vulnerability, the guerrillas then decided to turn him over to the Red Cross.
It was overwhelming for me. I couldn't digest it.
This was how Glenn became the only hostage to initiate his own rescue.
The FBI hostage release team said, you're going to California, you're going to be in a hospital. I said, no, I'm going to Argentina. They said, you're serious, you want to keep going. We just thought you were crazy and didn't know what you want. I said, I am crazy, but I know what I want. And I've got to keep going. If I don't continue, they win. The healing factor was going out and meeting the people of the world, look them in the eye, shake their hand, say howdy. My name's Glenn Hegstad, and I'm from California. Came here to meet you and write about you.
monare fitile mona. Fitile monare le motoka re le mona metse
pele.
Malaba le mavane ronare fitile mona. Fitile monare le motoka re le mona metse
pele.
Malaba le mavane ronare fitile mona. Fitile monare le motoka re le mona metse
pele.
Malaba le mavane ronare fitile mona. Le monare le moko kare le mona miti
bimbo. Washunzu wati lapo kwa makona amanzi apinde apinde ame isisu somhami asinga ganani singa ngenzo yenoni au khe khe khe.
I think I'd always want to be remembered as somebody that had to find out for himself, and that when he did, he shared that experience with as many people as he possibly could. And probably one of the most important words is inspiration, to try to do something that affects other people's lives in a positive manner, whether it was teaching martial art or now to go out and see what the world is really like and meet the people of the world and go back and tell people, hey, it's not like we saw in the media. It's not like we saw in the news. These people don't hate us. These people want peace just like we do. The one universal thing that every human being in the world wants, and that's respect.